In this video, Ask F5 shows you how to use a BIG-IP APM system to create an access policy for multi-factor authentication with Active Directory authorization and a one-time password using a built-in macro. Multi-factor authentication, or MFA, is a best practice that enhances authentication by requesting two or more authentication factors. The scenario for using this policy is to have users provide a password that the BIG-IP system evaluates against Active Directory. The system then automatically generates a one-time password and transmits it to the user through external SMS. For more information, including prerequisites and how to configure the HTTP AAA server to have the system send a one-time password, refer to this article linked below. Start by creating your access profile. Log into the configuration utility. Go to Access, Profiles, Policies. Select Create and enter a name for your access profile. For profile type, select All. Under Language Settings, for Language, in the factory built-in languages, select English and move it to the accepted languages list, then select Finished. Go to the access policy you just created, and for per session policy, select Edit to open the Visual Policy Editor. Select Add New Macro. For Select Macro Template, select AD Auth Query OTP by HTTP and Resources Macro. Select Save. Expand the macro you just created. Now configure the policy items. Select the AD Auth policy item. For server, select your existing AAA AD server, then select Save. Select the AD Query policy item. For server, select your existing AAA AD server. Select Add New Entry. For required attributes optional, enter mobile. Make any other configuration updates you require in AD Query and select Save. Select the OTP delivery by HTTP policy item. Select your AAA server and select Save. Select the full resource assigned policy item. Select Add New Entry. Select Add Delete. Now add the resources to assign to your users and select Update. Select Save. Add the macro to the access policy using the login flow. Between the start and deny ending, select the Add icon. Select Macros. And then select the macro you created and select Add Item. On the successful branch, change the endpoint from deny to allow by selecting deny, select allow, and select save. Now select apply access policy. And that's it. If you have any other questions you'd like to see answered on this channel, leave a message below or send us an email. Thank you for watching.